just move this down. Yeah, there we go. Ooh, Demacia. Wait, Demacia is a small kingdom? Aren't they supposed to like rival Noxus? Is Noxus also a small kingdom? Okay, that's some driving right there. How to win attacking and champions. I've like just barely seen some people streaming, so I've seen units, but I don't really know anything. Okay. So card, this is Garen, a champion. I'm not entirely sure what actually indicates that he's a champion. I assume this is actually the Demacia symbol, right? Before things get going too much. Full screen mode audio. Play Garen. Does it matter where I summon it to? Okay, it'll always summon to this. I just put it out on the board. This is how much damage. So left is power. Health. When I've struck one, wow, that's like, what? So playing a unit comes here. This is the bench. Okay, we take turns akin to artifact, right? Like turn, like it's somewhere between magic, like the premise of the magic stack, but not, I guess it wouldn't be the stack, it would be turn orders, like player phases. And we are essentially just passing and playing stuff. Feels, I'm thinking it's gonna play out similar to the Legend of the Five Rings version by Fantasy Flight Games. You went first, summon Garen, your opponent pass, so you act again. Nexus, so health totals here on the left. Yeah, because it's just attacking straight across, right? And commit to the attack. So then they put blockers out. Driven is blocking your attack, which means it's your action again, but you don't have any cards yet. So click OK to resolve. Oh, strike is. Oh. Strike is literally just engaging combat. So what, he just becomes a 7/7? Is that, and so he goes from being a 6 mana 6/6 to a 7/7. Yeah, prepare to attack. So I'm okay, so they pass. So they could skip combat? I guess so, only the person who. So whoever has the attack is the one who gets to declare if there's combat. Super basic, just kind of showed the layout of the cards. Ooh. Well, a 3/3 trample Poro or overwhelm, because I've been hearing people say overwhelm is trample, and I know what trample is. When I'm summoned, draw two Poros if you have a Poro ally. I guess that's Freylord. Would champions, I guess champions have level ups. I've survived 10 total damage. Okay. If they're gonna shuffle cards as a load screen, well then I've got some shuffling up to do. Okay. Oh, progress 2 out of 4, blocking and followers. Interesting. So I'm on the defensive there on the attack. Mighty Burrow. Mighty Pearl is a follower. Unlike champions, followers cannot level up. Okay, so we play. This isn't the one I unlocked, right? Because it's this block. 2-2, 2-2. 5-5 trample. Oh no! And block with Braum, and block something here, right? Ooh. I mean. I think I still lose from there. Like even Darius is like, Braum's awesome. Survive run one. While letting any pros die. Okay. I mean, I can do math. This is where I didn't actually like read the cards. Sure. I'm not entirely sure. Spider Queen will dominate your foes. I can't tell what those icons are. And I, like, honestly, I don't know too much of the lore from characters after, I guess, approximately Shyvana was released. Back and forth actions. Use mana to play your cards. You start the game with 1 mana. Okay. So the Hearthstone system. Spiderling costs 1 mana. Play Spiderling. Attack. Summon a Spiderling. At the start of the round, level up if you have 3+ spiders. Okay, so Elise goes next. So the opponent. Remember, you can only attack every other round. This game, your enemy goes first, you'll be able to attack next round. Okay, so does that mean that there's no haste? Like, or summoning sickness? Like, I'm not entirely sure. Each round, your mana refills and you gain an additional mana gem. Okay. So, can I attack with both? Is there anything? Nope, it's just a 1-1. This is just a on attack, right? I don't want to attack with the spiderling. Because they can block. Fine. Tutorial. Okay, so I went to the attack step. I see. So if you don't put any units out, there's no attack phase, is what seems to be the way. When both players pass without acting, the round ends. So there's no summoning sickness, really. It's just whether you're on the defense or not. But when I'm summoned two wrench bombs. When I squished 1,000 spiders. House spider. Okay. And then it would be the spiderling. Wait. What? Oh, right. I'm not attacking. Yeah. It still doesn't make sense why I can't summon that spider. You still have one. Like, I assume it's because of the tutorial. It's most likely. So, you still have 1 minute to spend. Oh, it just wants to show that you can use your mana after combat. And now at the start of the round. So you can only block with one creature at a time. That makes toughness, like health, matter a lot. You're on your own. Help Elise defeat the revered inventor. How many attackers? 5? Least dials. So that was done getting to play after I initiated combat. And how is the best way to do this? So that doesn't die. This is definitely a strange flow. So it's making sure you're aware of who's attacking. Okay, so it's round 6. Let's see if I can keep track of this. Okay, so round 6, I'm the one who gets to attack. I get first action. So I would want to play the spiderling first because this is on summon. I have 5 mana. And then I don't have any action. If I didn't put anything out, I could just end the round and can't play. Okay, I just accidentally grabbed that one. That wasn't so bad now, was it? I should have tried to keep something alive and see if I could have I guess I didn't have that one cost spiderling in my hand. So there's no summoning sickness, so you can get really aggressive. Lux barrier. What's barrier? I guess I won't tell me here. Ooh, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Shuffle! Now, I am definitely a bit of an, like, I can get pretty addicted to card games. I think the only problem, like, I'm a kind of a Magic the Gathering fan. The only problem I have is that I get way too competitive with it. Like, I can't not try to aim for the Pro Tours, and but I'm also in a position where I can't really do that. Now with Arena, it's almost more possible, but it's just too much of a time commitment. So maybe someday I'll end up back in Arena. I think the bigger problem is just I can't play enough to make it actually free to play. For the most part, I put in like $200 when Arena came in out of beta. What is this? You drew a spell. Spells are powerful cards that can. Okay, so the fact that it doesn't have power toughness. What is burst? Spell speed. Burst spells are the fastest spells in the game. They take effect immediately and don't count as taking an action. Okay, yeah, sure, I'll draw. I love drawing cards. Give an ally barrier. Yeah, so it's Divine Shield. Well, it's a little worse than Divine Shield because it's only for the turn. But yeah, when Arena came out, I put in like a couple hundred bucks and I pretty much had a full set up until rotation. But I started running out of wild cards and stuff because I can play enough during the month. Summon an attacking, so it's like Elise with the spiderling, but Zed stats and Living Shadow. Oh wait, it's a. This unit dies when it strikes or when the round ends. Okay. I wonder if there's eventually gonna be some reason for. Oh no! They gained health. When. I've seen you cast six mana of spells in a round. Wait. Why is it a 3 out of 6? Given a. So this is. Split second, essentially. So it's like, oh no, that sucks. The Zed gets to stay alive, but at the same time, my magic background tells me that by doing that, I made them spend the card to switch. So, 3 of this becomes spell mana. Use your spell mana to cast Final Spark. So, how. Is there a cap? Oh, okay. There we go. So, once it's in the middle, then you draw the line. Ah, got it. I got it. Lux levels up. Whoa. On attack? Oh, okay. It's not cast a final spark. It's create. So every other turn. I guess I just win, right? Like, huh? Oh, enemy unit. Enemy unit. Okay, yeah. That would have. I was like, well, that's just a win. Okay, spell mana is capped at 3. Oh, I should have cast decisive action, right? That's it still have 8. And now I would be responsible for putting my units out. So that's definitely gonna take some. It takes a bit of like mental. You gotta like really think about it, because it for most games it's like once you put the unit like forward, it's like okay, this is while I'm attacking, but you don't go into your attack step unless you put units out. So that's it makes a lot of sense, but it's so not what people did for a long time. So definitely is it. Interesting take. Aims to gain XP, complete the prologue. As a special bonus, you're receiving a ton of wild cards to make decks. Oh, yeah. It's Jinx. Stealth and cunning. Piltover and Zaun and the subtlety of Ionia's stealthy warriors in this new starter deck. Wait a second. Piltover and Zaun, are they. Is that one? Okay, so everything is this scale. I don't know how many it's. Is it like one game? Sure, I'll play a game with this Zaun Piltover deck. And then I'll take a look at some of these cards. In so replace Hearthstone style Mulligan. Inspiring Mentor play. Grant an ally in hand +1/+1. When you summon an ally, give me +0 this round. So this one wants you to summon after it. Can only be blocked by an elusive unit. If you draw a card, give me plus. When you so it's a 2/2 really. I'll mulligan that because I'm gonna play the Inspiring Mentor. It says give an ally +3. Okay. Last breath, summon a spiderling. Hapless aristocrat. Okay. I'm digging it. I know. I've seen this kind of thing. Yeah, and I'll block because I don't care. So unfortunately, it's a 1/1. Is elusive can only block as well? Wanna. Can only be blocked by an elusive unit. Okay, no, it's just when cast or discarded, summon a scrap scuttler. What the heck is a scrap scuttler? Okay, oh, that's so nice. So they can't actually block this thing. kind of confused. Okay, so this is really just a, it's a flash 1/1, right? But oh, it's a, it okay, so it's a 1/1 that can that has flash or like madness for free. So that's interesting. Yeah, I'm kind of seeing this the combo potential in this faction. Because I could actually summon multiple units in a round. And I can do it at instant speed. So does this, when I'm summoned, refill your spell mana? Does that mean I get three spell mana? Is that the point of that? I want to summon this. I'm on the defensive for this round. So what's the trigger for this? Phantom Prankster. When another ally dies, deal one damage to the enemy Nexus. Okay. So they essentially want their spiderlings to die. Okay, so it's Aristocrats. For non Magic players, Aristocrats was a MTG deck archetype. That when it was first founded had a bunch of cards named Aristocrats, but the themed wait, what's this? Drain one from a unit, summon a spiderling. And this only gives, yeah, well, I'm gonna take one for like if I kill it, I take one anyway. So the premise is you have creatures that when they died, they'd make other creatures. You'd have creatures that benefited by sacrificing. Like it'd get an extra plus one if you sacrificed a creature. And then you had things that when they saw anything on the field die, it would deal damage to your opponent. So the entire premise was you could kill your opponent. By attacking with a bunch of 1/1s, and then when they were able to block you, you could just sacrifice all your stuff and deal that last damage. Create an attacking. Okay, so. So there. I'm gonna. Okay. So they could. Maybe summoning Zed wasn't that great. So if I did that, you I think I'm willing to trade that damage. So they're gonna take, oh yeah, so this is 9, 10, 11, 11, 14. Okay, so from he well, that means next turn they're pretty much dead. Strike. Reduce the cost of the most expensive unit in your hand by one. Interesting. Wait, play, heal anything three. Kindly Tavern Keeper. That it was just like a lot. The TAV was like, the text is kind of awkwardly spaced. I'm gonna summon because it's not like I can keep this spell mana. Forever. Oh wait, I'd have to do this, right, to actually be able to trade. Okay, that was actually fairly intuitive. Yeah, so this is going to be pretty gross. Support, give my supporter ally. Well, wait, what support? Okay, support. Attacking with a support unit will buff the unit to its right. Okay. So, when I put the Zed out on the field, I want to make sure it's like, how do I, okay, I guess it's always gonna load it like that. And this is a burst. Oh shoot, yeah. I messed that up a little bit because I should have played the Eager Apprentice. Kill an ally, draw two. And so I just took two. I don't know how it'll work when another ally dies. Okay, so it won't. They won't trigger from themselves. That's gonna kill these, so they'll still have to block. Yeah. Oh, what? Attack, create, and attacking limit shadow stats and keywords. So now it they'll have first strike. You draw a card, give me plus one plus zero. I'm now I don't have draw cards, so you could tell it's a pre-con. So it'll have elusive. Well, I can't attack, right? So yeah, it's like yeah, at this point, this 1-1 isn't really gonna be make or break. I don't wanna go to five. Like that feels like I'm just asking to to end up getting killed next turn. So now it'll be my turn to attack from here. Yeah, I definitely messed that up. Thermogenic Beam. To play, spend all your mana, deal that much damage to a unit. There's no reason for me to attack with that thing. This is slow, so unfortunately, I wouldn't be able to respond. But they're both gonna have elusive and quick attack. Frostbite an enemy? Setting his power to. What? Well, why didn't they block that? I'm surprised they didn't just block this. Because it doesn't have elusive, right? I don't get to attack this turn. Overwhelm is a little worrisome. So I'm gonna take three, right? Oh shoot. I can only block with one thing. Right? Oh, lordy, lordy. But they still have to deal with my Zed? I'm trying to think if maybe I don't want to attack, but doesn't feel great. I didn't really draw cards. I think there's too much benefit, like this one where it's try to draw cards, try to play cards, and it needs to maybe be focus a little bit more. Does Overwhelm deal damage? Excess damage I deal to my blocker is dealt to the enemy Nexus. Okay. So it's only on attack. I win. 100% win rate. Simple as that. Right when you're watching this and you're looking for your first team of challengers or like your Twitch rivals, 100% win rate right now. Okay, so if I wanted to do, I see. Interesting. Oh, way of filtering it. Filter by spells, units. Filter by mana. I think it's a little weird that there's champion rarity, but there's also, wait, let's see. Okay, so the bottom, so this triangle thing. So the yellow one must be the champion, even though it kind of the shape is a little weird. Okay, yeah, so definitely by color. Although the epic and the champion rarity kind of look similar. So it's triangle, diamond, then it's the sort of crest looking. Your quick attack. So what does she become when she levels up? Start of round, draw one. The first time you empty your hand, each round create a fleeting super mega death rocket in hand. To play, discard. Wait, when did she get excited? What? Fleeting. Fleeting cards discard from hand when the round ends. Okay, so they're temporary spells. But where does excited? To play, discard one, deal three to anything, shuffle a Jinx into your deck. Slow, okay. Can be cast outside of combat and other casting. Okay, so sorcery speed. Fleeting cards, discard from hand. Okay, is this a fleeting card? So that one's fast. Slow. So on top of it saying it in the text, it has an icon. That's really good. I can understand why it would be slow. I was not a fan of that beam. Okay, so probably don't want that. Summon two exact copies of an ally. They're ephemeral. So I can do. Okay, so if I did it with Zed, the Zeds would then make copies. So I could be attacking with six Zeds when I cast this spell. Discard your hand, draw three. That actually seems kind of nuts because if you have zero cards in hand, you draw. But then you really don't. Definitely don't want a five cost that is only playing, like, helping things in my hand. When I'm summoned. Okay, that's strike, draw spell. Wasn't exactly excited for that. To play, discard one. Okay, so that's where this thing comes into play, right? How do I add? What is it? Oh, is the deck building restriction that you can only have two of a card? Give an ally +1/+0 on quick attack this round. That's a great spell, Inspiring Mentor. Grant an ally in hand. The fact that it's a one cost is actually the. I don't know about that one. Show unowned. Teemo. Wait. He's part of Piltover. Okay. So, plant. Remove deck, shuffle. What? Deal one to your Nexus. So, it's RNG. Can only be blocked by elusive unit. Fleeing, create a mystic shot in hand. You've targeted enemy units 8 times. Deal 2 damage to anything, but it costs 2 mana. You've targeted enemy units 8 times. Oh, okay. Nexus Strike, create a fl well. This one. So I have to cast a ton of spells before those things get and I have to target enemy. Counterfeit copies. Pick a card in hand, shuffle 4 exact copies of it into your deck. No, that seems. Deal 1 damage. Caustic cast. These abilities take effect when the unit dies. Okay. So this is really just a unit that I could block with. It's a spell to deal 1 damage to both Nexus and possibly gain a tiny bit of life, but that requires summoning a unit. When you stun or recall an enemy, I deal 2 damage to it. What is stun? Remove from combat. It can't attack or block for the round. Recall. End of round, create a random spell in hand. You're enlightened. Okay, so that would require like ramp, I think. I've seen all allies gain barrier 4+. What? I've seen all allies gain barrier 4 times. I've seen allies. I was just hovering. Okay, I've seen allies. So, four attacks from Shen, right? Because support is attacking with a support unit will buff the unit, so it's right. Or I have something else that would give it barrier. What are the turrets? Create a fleeting turret in hand. Well, which one's a turret? Like, is it just any of these? Because there's only two things that even mention being like turrets. I'm like ant on that. Let's see, what other spells can we take advantage of? So Poro is elusive. Okay, so if I gain barrier. Okay, so here that's an interesting combo. So the Shen can be paired up with the Green Glade Caretaker, give it the barrier, and it becomes a 3-2. And it doesn't go away at end of turn. When I'm summoned, give me. So this is particularly great on the offense. To play, discard two, draw two. To play me, discard one, last breath, draw one. Wait, what the f quick attack? It's just. Quick attack is while attacking strikes before its blocker. So. It has first strike while you're the attacker. Okay, that's. I like. First strike is so broken. O2 that just deals two, but it doesn't have elusive and stuff, so it's easy to block. Fey Blade Twirler. When you send or recall a unit, grant me plus two plus zero. Okay, so this doesn't require me to. It doesn't end. And it doesn't. I can recall my own units. Flame Chompers. When I'm discarded, summon me. Can choose which enemy unit blocks. Well, what? Okay, so I can just. Oh, I can. This will. It kind of gives my other units elusive a couple times. That makes sense. Herald of Spring. Give my supported ally lifesteal this round. Me. Instead of Aegis, create a random spell in hand and then create two instead. Keeper Mask. When I'm summoned, give other allies. Grant barrier to an ally in hand. Draw one. That doesn't seem great. It does draw a card. The Scrap Scuttlers are just 1/1, so it's that's good for a bunch of units to play me. Recall an ally. Well, when I'm summoned, summon. When I'm summoned? So, oh, if I could pump it in hand, that's what it wants. Nexus Strike, create a copy of me in hand. Okay, so this is elusive. It's functionally a it if you remember what makes it so creatures function as a spell. The only issue with support is that you can't choose the card you play, so you really so it does I was messing with it because I was using support in the game before. What's up, Amanda? So I played the unit, but then I played the unit I wanted to support after it, because it seems to always put whatever you're putting onto the board to the right. Like, it always fills out to the right. So at least that's what it looked like. Maybe I just kind of fumbled with it. Okay, the order you play units, not as in the order I play them from my hand, like in Hearthstone, where it's like you can't really rearrange once they're on the board, but just which one you put into combat at a given time. I could see where with the timer, that could start getting a bit a little finicky. So I've been looking at this Piltover Zaun deck, and I'm just trying to figure out where I want to go with. I definitely want to draw more cards for to be able to benefit from the Astute Academic. And which one? So this one requires summoning allies, but the ally there's some spell allies. Is this guy really even good? Because it's strike. Okay, it could repeat. So, it strike only when you attack. Or something that has strike on it, so I can just double check. Deal damage to an enemy using the unit's power. Okay, so it doesn't actually care whether it's defense or offense. An Ionia Demacia deck focused on Fiora. I haven't actually looked at the cards too much because I was like, maybe I'll get in pretty quick so I can experience it firsthand. Oh no, dang it. Okay, you have to click on the number. Is that how this works? Is it just that I don't own copies of that? Okay, that's. And then I would have to. The thing that really threw me off is the 2-card limit. So and because health doesn't heal, do champions go back into your deck when they die? No, right? So you and I don't know if recalling counts. So you'd have to like give her barrier pretty much. Is that the idea of how you would make it work? Barrier or healing her? Is there like an easy way if I want to add more of these units, I can craft it. Is there not an easy way to craft this thing? Unfortunately, it does not look like that. There's no way to do it from the menu. That makes sense. I was looking at Shen. I was like kind of impressed by Shen and what was it? It was Shen and there was this creature that was whenever you gain shield. I have two of that already, right? So I don't know why it's recall when I'm summoned, recall all other allies. I'm not sure how I feel about that. Recall an ally, summon a living shadow in its place. That is. I guess the living shadow would be a copy. There was something here. Create a copy of me in hand. So this deal, like, if it deals damage, you get more of it, but it's going to die. Okay, Grab Dash Assembly. Now I get it where that would be. And there's a creature. All right. So Challenger, because like, I'm still wrapping my head around the idea of like, well, you can only block with one creature, and now I haven't really seen a whole bunch of Challenger cards. Go for a second. The one thing my kid is really not gonna be doing by herself for a little bit is wiping her bum. So, every once in a while, I have to go help her. Oh yeah, it's also at this point, how can you be confident that you found the best version of the deck when there's a whole bunch of combinations and there's no good theory or sense of what's good tempo? You can apply some fundamentals from different card games, but until you really try some things and see, like, oh yeah, I know this card isn't doing what I'm expecting. So on a card that says discard two, because you might have had this interaction, like Rummage, to play discard two, draw two. If you have no cards in hand, do you just draw two? Or is it like, so essentially there's like Faithless Looting where you discard then draw, but doesn't, or draw then discard. Okay, well then I'm going to be making this. Wait. Oh, is three the actual limit in a deck? Huh? Okay, so what? Why? Oh, I just can't craft additional copies here. Or can I? Was that just like I was having a little bit of a bug? So I like the idea of having things that I discard, especially to work with Zed and Jinx. No. I'm probably gonna play a bunch of Zed. Like, I'm looking at him and it's like everything about his ability just makes me think he's gonna be really strong. I mean, a 4/3 with quick attack just seems decent. So, okay, 40 cards. Oh, and the maximum you can have is 6 champions. That makes sense. Discard your hand, draw 3, deal 3 to anything. Shadow Assassin. So that's an interesting dilemma I would have. I don't think I'm getting free mana. I wasn't a super fan of just paying 2 for a 1/2, even if it did give elusive. I don't really care about lifesteal. Making things cheaper is pretty good. And I don't know, is a 3/1 quick attack like really that good? It's super great on the offense, I imagine. That dies when it deals damage? 4/3. To play me, discard one. Ooh. Okay, so look, I'm a sucker for combo discard. So let's see. Let's discard. Discard. Let's play me, discard. This one is, I'm not sure, because it benefits from discarding, like you discarding it, but it's still just a 0/3 challenger. So I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. When cast or discarded. So this is definitely a card that I would want extra of. This would make it yeah. I guess the idea is that it's still an 0/3, so it should survive one combat and then let you like almost grant elusive to something else. Like I could see where that might come from. Is there a way to see mana cost? Yeah, that seems about right. I definitely want a lot of spells. And the. So I'm gonna have to take a look. I guess that actually makes what's its face? The 2-cost lookout. Reduce the cost of the most expensive unit. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna make it in because it's gonna. I have other things I would want to do. This will benefit from those cards that I'm discarding. Rush, quick attack. Cheap, super cheap spell that looks pretty valuable, I assume. And I like just a really cheap 1/1 that it's essentially a two a one mana 2/2. When you draw a card, that's definitely good. I like the idea of having 8/1 cost because I think that's gonna be kind of safe. I didn't really care for the beam. Evasive. There we go for that. Mystic shot. Deal 2 damage to anything. It's a shock. Well, it's not even shock. It's worse than shock. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not excited by that one. Although it's very possible the ideal solution is instead of this like academic prodigy. I thought I crafted the third one. I'll assume a 3-1 first striker is decent. Although I know quick attack is only on the on your attack. At this point though, I'm running out of room anyway. So this is whenever I strike. So every time it deals damage, I think 6 mana. I don't know if the discard mechanic works the way I want it to, so I will play a little safe on that. To play, discard 2, draw 2. To play me, discard 1. And I think so I want to have my hand empty, so those extra draw cards are probably not great. And interesting. Because it's 40 cards, I can only have like a one of somewhere in here. Or like two ofs. The fact that it deals 3 to anything, I'll cut one of each of these. No, I think I'd rather have the River Shaper. Yeah, the River Shaper I think is correct over the Eager Apprentice. And now I've got my janky brew. So let's see if I can keep up this 100% win rate. I could probably play like this game and another game. Well, that is definitely too slow, so let's replace that to play. Do I want to do this? You know what? I think I want a one drop. Like an actual one drop would probably be better. Nailed it! Played perfectly. It's exactly what I planned the entire time. There was never any doubt. Okay, so next turn, I can play a two drop. After that, I can play a one drop and a two drop. I am not the attacker, so next turn I get to attack, and the turn after that, I think I'll give it to the elusive. So I'm gonna get to attack next turn, or now, right? So I can play this. I'm essentially attacking for the same amount as with this Academy Prodigy. The Ephemeral. The fact that it's 6 mana and it's Ephemeral, I'm thinking maybe I don't want 3 copies of it. So they just played a 3-2. This has elusive. 100% win rate. Look at that. Can't lose. Can't lose. Okay, That's a whole lot of stuff going on there. I attacked, they had to concede. It was they I'll give props to my opponent. They knew what was coming their way. It was a beating. Okay, level up, your hand is empty. Okay, so I don't want to have to discard Jinx. Okay. Ah, yes, the combo, it begins. Oh yeah. Oh, like, are you prepared for some really good value here? Like next turn. Oh, okay. Wait. Play Grim. Yeah. They figured my combo out. So I don't get to attack next turn, which is completely fine because I realistically wouldn't want to attack next turn. Kiddo stomping. That's an interesting. So I'm going to be on the defense, so I don't really do anything this turn, but that kind of works because next turn I can play Zed. That's interesting. That's definitely an interesting choice. Do they have any answers? Inspiring Mentor when I'm summoned. So they probably killed a Green Blade duo, right? Actually, I kind of got distracted and I forgot, like, they're obviously going to block there, so I should have attacked. I missed two damage. When I have struck the enemy, does it... So the clone? The Living Shadow counts? That surprised me. Okay, I can see. Well, that's definitely a bit of a pain. So, if I do try to block, I'm going to end up trading, right? Well, we're going to figure out next round. Yeah, I'll just block like this. I don't care about three damage. They'll have to have something to protect their Zed. Oh, quick attack. Quick attack. I'm a doofus. That makes a lot more sense. Okay. Since I'm attacking, I think I want to technically do this first. Yeah. And we'll figure out, because I'll do the get excited to discard that. So now we know. So let's discard this. Deal 3 damage to the Zed. And then this is going to be 4 damage. Because it's going to give plus 2, plus 2. If it works that way. We're doing some experimentations. Oh, that was me having to pass priority. Deny. Oh. Counter spells. No! What? What? They played the deny, and oh, you know what? It's a cost. It is a cost. So I definitely have to discard two. So that's something to know for the future. Cause look, I bet I can't cast it. Yep. Yep. Can't do it. Not the way they want it to work. Oh. Let's see. At the end of the round, create a spell in hand. Enlightened is 10 mana, right? Top two allies. It doesn't have overwhelm. I'll block with a 1/1. Ah, why did I do that? I shouldn't have played the academic, because I needed, like, when I drew a card this round. I guess I can play a 4/3. They have three blockers. They're only at one, so they have to stop everything. Frostbite two. Is there a log? Okay. Frostwinds. Okay. What is frostbite? I don't know what frostbite is. Why can't? Frostbite this round. Wait, what does frostbite? Opponent's turn. Okay, so they got priority first. That makes sense. Oh wait, does Mano, it leveled up? Oh no, it didn't level up, it's just gold bordered. Yeah. Start a round, draw one card. I love that it's like, end turn? Oh, no, you can't play spells, we're ending your turn. Hey, Jinx, you read my mind! So let's see, so I do this. So they get priority, right? Because I have a slow card, so I have to do it before combat, and you don't have a limit on how many cards you can cast before combat, right? So they do have a lot of cards. Okay. This costs 2 mana. So even if they deny. I like that it's the first time, because you just cast more rockets every single time. Okay, I like this deck. I definitely, now that I know the whole discard situation, I can make some tweaks. But we experimented. Discard is definitely a cost. Oh, what did they do? Right, like, 'cause it's gonna. Okay. Since it doesn't deal 4 damage to the enemy Nexus, it doesn't target. I guess it just does the thing. This is start of the round, draw one. I found something that was pretty good. Like, turns out my experience with magic—it's like I kind of piece some things together. And now we know that this is probably too much discard, right? Wait, what else was discard? So rummage involves discarding the sump dredge. So rummage is not card advantage. Now it does technically work better with the astute academic because it can kind of be a pump spell at instant speed. So that's something to consider. I don't know. I think get excited for discard one is probably just a little short of being something I really want to do. Now, this is a kind of interesting flex slot. I definitely do like the idea of the Shadow Assassin as just having. So the Augmented Experimenter. Discard your hand. Would this trigger Jinx? You know what? Oh, why don't we do this? Have it as a bit of a curve topper. I think this is aggressive enough that I want it. And Jinx is a really high payoff. Yeah, and I definitely want. Rummage makes way more sense than I get excited because I can find the Jinx. And that's pretty big. Because the only reason I won was that I played Jinx, and then it's a comeback mechanic all in by herself, right? So. I got time for one more. Then, unfortunately, today was the day that I'm switching. Like, my group switched to play Gloomhaven, so my evening isn't free. I definitely like having Zed. This is a bunch of two drops. I don't want to have to discard right away, I don't think. I think I'll replace these two, especially. Oh, I'm going next turn. Oh yeah. Oh, this is this is gross. Okay. So. Oh hey, while I'm on the defensive and it doesn't matter, I'm gonna put it on Zed. It makes the most sense on Zed because it's effectively a plus two plus two. Or plus one twice. Is how I should say it. So now they can summon a two cost defensive. That actually makes things really interesting as far as dynamics for gameplay, because you have a 50-50 shot that your one cost will actually be able to attack on the first turn. Because I think I saw Teemo is a one cost, and I think I saw someone play Teemo and like attack with it on the first turn, and then was like, oh yeah, this is great. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. I can have multiple of these out, right? So I'll summon the like this Zed. They'll be tempted to use removal on it. Okay. Let's go for it. Wait, what? What just happened? What did I miss? Oh, because there's two. Okay, there's already a Zed out on the field. That's how they handle it. Okay. Oh, wow, that's a new mechanic. So rather than there being a legend rule as far as magic goes, or having a restriction to only one in your deck, akin to Hearthstone, instead, what they do is it becomes a spell. Okay, that actually is bugging me a little bit as far as UI elements, is that I can't like summon onto this board. I have to drag it out onto the field, and it doesn't feel right. I have to actually think, deal three damage to an enemy, to another. Ooh, it's a Cone of Flame. Cone of Flame. That's actually seems pretty strong. So what am I? And that actually, they fell for my trap, because now, Nexus Strike, create a fleeting Mystic Shot in hand, and I'll take spell mana. This isn't like the most efficient, technically. Nexus Strike, create a Mystic Shot. So they have two mana. Mystic Shot costs two, so they can deal two damage. And I definitely want. So they're gonna kill the Jinx, which is totally cool. Because it means they don't have the Mystic Shot for Zed. So, 5, 6. I could have 9. Or I could have 7. So, I would be wasting one this turn. So, it actually makes sense to summon Zed here. It's a little disorienting. Let's do this. So they're dead? Are they effectively just dead? Because I'm attacking for 30. Like, if they don't have anything, these are. Yo, I heard you like Zeds, so we got Zeds for your Zeds to Zed. Oh, there's a limit of 6? So I shouldn't have put this astute academic. Interesting. That's actually so it's a limit of 6 on in combat, right? These games are actually going pretty fast. Like that one took 8 minutes. I guess I can even play one more. Like what? I haven't been live for 2 hours yet. I think I'll play it normal one more time, and then the next time I'm playing, I might just start doing ranked. So, 100% win rate. That definitely is a mulligan, but I think I'm happy with these. I'll pass. Okay, so Enraged, I think, is the Hearthstone version of that. And I don't have to worry about it until it actually starts taking damage. So, is that how this works? Deal 1 damage to an ally, grant. I don't want that thing to live. So they didn't want to attack? I think I'm in the end of turn phase, right? Like we're past. Oh, dang. How do I know when it's past combat? So it's okay. This is actually a pretty sweet maneuver here, because I'll attack with both of these prodigies. I've survived 10 total damage. Okay, wait. I should triple check this. While attacking, strikes before its blocker. Okay, so in this case, it's not really like I kill the things that would actually kill them, so they'll take 4 on Braum. Although I assume they have some way of healing Braum, and that's how you can level them up. Wait, is damage not till. Oh, I thought damage was permanent. That is a big mistake. Damage is not permanent? Or did I miss something in the log? Oh, he has some ability, doesn't he? Heals full regeneration. Okay. So, if I summon. So, next turn we have 5 mana. So, it makes the most sense to summon Jinx. Yeah. Unfortunately, there's no way to. So what does Braum do when he levels up? When I survive damage, summon a mighty Poro. Generate is a doozy. This Braum's gonna level up. Does it? So it has to take the damage. Then it's when I survive damage. So it wouldn't summon it the first time, right? Whatever damage deal two to the enemy nexus. So it won't survive damage. This was maybe a bad hand. Maybe I'd needed to mulligan either the Jinx or the Zed. Also, I probably should have read what Broma actually had, since I hadn't seen the potion bottle yet. So, they're taking a lot of damage. If they don't block something else, it's 14. What? Well, levels up. That confuses me a little, since recall an ally to summon a living shadow in this place. The living shadow is just a 3/2. I'll skip the block. Discard your hand. Draw 3. Is that how I want to do this? Ooh. I haven't seen Vladimir attack. For each other attacking ally, deal 1 to it and 1 to the enemy nexus. Oh, that is. That seems like a bit of a beating. So if they have regenerator, things like this where. Quick strike. And then the shadow will be spawned, so that's all 6 spots, right? Yeah. You've had 6 out of survive damage. So they definitely misplayed, right? Because they should have played it before they attacked with Braum last round. I guess that's a bit of the interface. So I have lethal, right? Oh no. Yeah, so I definitely want to burst or rush on Jinx. Deal 1 damage to an ally, give another ally plus. For each other attacking ally, deal. Oof. Gonna trade. Oh, jeez. I think this actually, because drawing cards is probably how I'm going to be able to recover from here. I can kill the Vlad, right? So. Deal three to anything. I'll kill the Vlad. Because that could get them. That could definitely get out of hand. Oh, because it has regeneration too. Yeah, no, I'm definitely. Is this gonna be a rummage situation? Yeah, I don't think. Discard two. Yeah, this is pretty much perfect. When I survive damage, grant me. Okay, so there's gonna be a lot of damage stuff there. But not incredibly worried. They're ephemeral, so. Oh wow, you can actually pick the block from the bench. They're at five. Let's overwhelm, and it's gonna get a damage bonus. I'll skip blocks. Then this will benefit from. I kind of waste a little bit of mana on this turn. But I think they're gonna waste some too. Deal one to anything. Okay, sure. Deal another one damage. Kill a damage unit. You can cast this again this round. Oh, I guess it doesn't matter. What is this one? It's for. So. What. Ah, oh, dang. How can I. Guess there's no real way to. Yeah, and then I can do Dawn and Dusk. Oh wait, that's gonna be. Deal one damage to anything. Okay, well now they literally don't have. Copy the Zed, and then I'll get at least three damage through. This will die. It'll summon another one. This will be a bit of a higher power. Oh, wonder what happens if, because I think the Zed. Do they level up? My shuttles and I have struck the enemy Nexus twice. But I don't have either, and only one of them's gonna get through. Yeah, that makes sense.
I got makeup.
Oh, you put on some pretty little makeup? Ooh. Oh yeah, you got like such pretty nails.
They're called pink and purple.
Pink and purple nails.
It's pink. Could I move that to you, but I didn't it.
They should have not blocked the normal one.
Not that.
Like I'm so those blocks are weird.
You mean a block? Like a ball is a block?
So I take 9? Don't want to do that. Don't want to take 9. Cause it's overwhelm. They only have one card in hand, so it's probably like plus 3. I'll skip blocks. Yeah, I might as well summon this mentor. Well, I'm almost done playing. Yeah. This is Legends of Runeterra.
Yeah, but I'm sitting on the ball.
Yeah. But you're... Well, Papa won. He's done.